is an interesting one. This is about Lily Rose Depp. And I feel like it has some parallels with the things that I've been talking about when it comes to stand-up comedians on my live stream, The Random Show. And when it comes to stand-up comedians, I feel like one of the main criticisms that comes towards somebody like a Brendan Schaub is the fact that he doesn't recognize or acknowledge the advantages that he's been given and the opportunities he's been given through his relationship and close friendship with someone like a Joe Rogan and maybe the platform that he has with The Fighter and the Kid and all that stuff. It's basically allowed him to jump the queue when it comes to comedy or even just his career as a content creator overall. But for some reason, he seems to be really unable to recognize that that influence played a large part in the fact that he is the person that he is now at the moment, but he doesn't want to recognize it. And I feel like Lily Rose Depp's situation that she's currently going through, where a bunch of models are attacking her because she came out in this interview with Elle and essentially poo-pooed the idea that her being a nepotism baby had anything to do with her success in modeling, and she thinks that it was all to do with her hard work. I feel like what Lily Rose is saying is something that is echoed by a lot of nepo quote-unquote babies. There's a small community of them, right? I can think of a Tracy Ellis Ross. Big up her, big up auntie. There's not a lot of other examples of nepotism babies who are, or people who are born from families who have an outsized influence in culture or who are famous in their own regard and have the ability to give their kids every opportunity needed in order for them to advance their career. There's a very small contingent of those nepotism babies who are, you know, who are aware of the advantages that they've been given and acknowledge them and just do the work. There's very little of them. For the majority of them, it feels like they go out of their way to fight against that nepo baby label, not acknowledge the advantages that they've been given by, you know, by the luck of being born to the family they've been born into, and just attribute all their success to hard work. A good example being that Kim Kardashian rant about hard work and about people not working hard enough. I'm sure, like I've said many times to people in real life when they ask me about the Kardashians, because I guess people just assume that I would hate them, but I don't. And I've always said that I don't think it's easy to be a Kardashian, to be like a full-time essentially influencer of your own body and you want to look a particular way. It's not easy. Even if you're getting surgery, you still have to work out, you still have to abstain yourself from eating certain things, you still have to sleep a certain amount of time, you still maybe have to avoid hard drugs and alcohol for the most part. There are things you have to sacrifice and do to keep your body in prim shape so you can fit in supple clothes, go and do shoots, fly around the world. It's not an easy job. I'm pretty sure, much sure, it's not an easy job. But for Kim Kardashian to stand there and say anybody could look like them, anybody can do the things that they do if they just worked harder, is incredibly insulting. Because essentially, if you weren't born into that family that allowed you the ability to experiment with your career, to take some chances, to avoid certain pitfalls that other people in your age group can get into, or just the hard luck of being brought up in an area where you don't leave your area and you have an unfortunate passing before the age of 21, so you can't even fulfill your dreams, all those play into it, all those play a part in the person you end up being as an adult. But for some reason, I don't know why it is, but nepotism baby can never figure it out. And I, for one, don't get it, because I've always thought to myself, if I was a nepo baby and I was born into a family of, you know, wealth, privilege and influence, I of course would use it to do the thing that I wanted to do, whether it was be a photographer, start my own magazine, have a creative agency. But there'd be no need to comment on these nepotism baby, you know, topics or conversation pieces, because I know that me being brought into that family, or born into that family, sorry, has given me advantages that other people probably aren't privy to. That is quite obvious to see. But I'm going to prove myself by doing the work. Maybe my parents got me the position, cool, but I'm going to keep the position by being really good at my job. And that's something I've never really understood why these nepo babies don't do. But I guess, like I was mentioning earlier about me having this trope or this cope that I do about no friends, it's basically a kind of shield for an insecurity. Maybe this is what they're doing with these nepo babies. Maybe they're so insecure about the fact that they're a nepo baby that immediately when it comes up, they just want to be defensive about it, because you don't feel good, you know, having people look at you thinking you're only there because of your dad or because of your mum. So I can understand the trepidation around it. The interesting thing about me with Lily Rose Depp is that high fashion Twitter, for the most part, was celebrating her because they felt like she was a perfect match for Chanel. She looked good in the clothes. It kind of matched her aesthetic. And it was maybe the defining moment in her quote-unquote modeling career that was going to take her to the next level. But then as soon as she opened her mouth and started talking, people immediately started to realize why they weren't necessarily the biggest fans of her as a person and why maybe, you know, she doesn't necessarily get it overall. And it completely turned on a flipping sixpence, which is absolutely incredible. So let's see where the quote is. I forgot where it is. Let me just actually search here. Nepo baby. There you go. Yeah. Speaking of internet opinions, has she heard about the Nepo baby conversation? She laughs dryly. I'm familiar. Depp sounds resigned to it, which is maybe one all can be in her situation. The internet seems to care a lot about that kind of stuff. People are going to have a preconceived ideas about how or how you got there. And I can definitely say that nothing is going to get you to the part except for being right for the part, she says. The internet cares a lot more about who your family is than the people who are casting you in things. Maybe you get your foot in the door, but you still just have your foot in the door. There's a lot of work that comes after that. She does find it interesting, however, that she rarely hears anyone refer to a man as a Nepo baby. Incorrect. It's weird to me to reduce somebody to the idea that they're only there because of their generational thing. It just doesn't make any sense. If somebody's mum or dad is a doctor and the kid becomes a doctor, you're not going to be like, well, you're only a doctor because your parent is a doctor. It's like, no, I went to medical school and trained. Ever careful, she's quick to add that she by no means comparing her work to that of somebody in the medical field. Okay, cool. I was about to say, I just hear it a lot more from women. And I think that is, and I don't think that's a coincidence. Okay, there's so many things wrong with this, it doesn't make any sense. The internet seems to care about a lot of these things than most people. That would be true because most people on the internet are just average, everyday people. They're not people of privilege, they're not people that work in the industry, they don't see stuff that behind the scenes. So all you can do is comment on stuff from just what you see in front of you. And that revolves around a lot of gossip, it involves a lot of conjecture, and a lot of just mindless rambling. That's the nature of people viewing stuff on the internet. You're going to see it. You're going to comment on it. It is what it is, right? That's not that big of a deal. And then I also think that there's an element of some people out there who clearly aren't where they want to be in life. And sometimes you look at other examples of people who are maybe your age mates or in your age range or your peers. And you think to yourself, how did they get there? How am I working my ass off? You know, in however you perceive that to be, but I'm not closer to my dreams, yet this person is considerably younger than I am and they've landed a flipping campaign with Chanel. How'd that happen? You Google their name. Then you start seeing their parents' name in blue, which means they've got a hyperlink, which means they've got a page on their, you know, their own parents have a page. You click on it and you realize, oh, damn, that's who their parents are. Now it makes complete sense. And it could do two things to you. It could either deflate you and make you bummed out in terms of you're never going to have those parents and that's the main reason why you're not successful. What's the point? Give up. Or it's going to alleviate some of your self-talk, some of your insecurity, some of your anxiety and let you know that your journey may be a little bit longer or different than this person because they had these advantages that you weren't privy to. That can happen also. And it continues here. This part I thought was really, really interesting. I can definitely say that nothing is going to get you to the part except for being right for the part. The internet cares a lot more about who your family is and the people who are casting you in these things, which again is a weird chasm of a flipping blind spot, because what she's not understanding is that behind the scenes, before she gets into the room, calls are being made, texts are being exchanged to make that experience, you know, easy. Or things are happening without her even knowing. People, maybe casting directors, maybe assistants, are Googling and checking your social media profiles before you arrived, realizing you're somebody of some sort of repute or some sort of fame, which I imagine would happen way before that. But still, all these things are happening before you even set foot on set. So that will maybe influence people's reaction to you, how you kind of navigate the space, whether there's a selection process, it might even get you the job. These are things that are happening without you even being aware of it. These are all things that were happening before you even conceived, right? These advantages were being laid down because your parents basically were successful in whatever field they were successful in, which maybe carried some favors and some connections, some network. These are all things happening outside of your kind of purview. So the fact that she's not aware of them is quite it's understandable, but also a little bit LOL-y in that regard. We continue. I hate how she says in this bit, maybe you get your foot in the door, but you still just have your foot in the door, as if the foot in the door isn't everything. How many of us would die, would kill to have a foot in the door in whatever industry that we're hoping to make it in just so we can prove ourselves? Most of us are like that, right? Myself included, I think of my DJing stuff. I never want to be given an opportunity based on the color of my skin or where I'm from, ever in a million years. But if somebody gave it to me and said, hey, this is your foot in the door, that would be my foot in the door to show and prove that despite you giving me this position or this opportunity based on the color of my skin, I'm actually good enough for the job. I can perform. I can do the thing that you need me to do. I'm actually good at this, but I just need the opportunity to show that I'm good at this. And some of us don't even get the opportunity to show and prove. Some of these castings that she's going to are closed. They're not for anybody to walk into. You have to be part of a particular agency. They're already vetted before you even turn up to the flipping building. Do you know what I mean? So this idea that a foot in the door is just a foot in the door is something somebody of privilege will say. Because it's as if like, oh, we've all got the same 24 hours. Yeah, to a certain extent. But some of us have things, you know, if you're looking after an entire family and you're 18, your 24 hours isn't the same as some girl who, you know, goes to Yale and also is a full-time social media influencer on the side. She maybe has more time in the day to do the stuff she wants to do because she doesn't have to look after, you know, a little brother, a mum that may be incapacitated and a dad that's not present. That's completely different type of 24 hours. So this is a little bit infuriating, but it continues. It's weird to me to reduce somebody to the idea that they're only there because of the generational thing, which no one said, actually. People just said it can play a part. No one says anybody's there only because of their parents. It plays a part. You still have to keep the job, unless it's politics or whatever it may be, right? Some, you know, what's that thing about Joe Biden's son being some consort to Ukraine in a field he has no expertise in? Those are clearly jobs just given to keep somebody on the straight and narrow and whatnot, whatever. But for the most part, even if you are a Nepo baby and you get your foot in the door, no one says you got the entire job for 17 years only because of your parents, or you're only there because of your parents. Maybe you got your foot in the door because of your parents, but clearly you are capable enough to keep that job for that amount of time, so you may be adequate enough at your job to keep a job. That makes complete sense. I get that. No one actually said that. She's arguing to no one. But it continues here. Equating being a model or an actress to being a doctor is laughable. By saying, if somebody's mom or dad is a doctor, then the kid becomes a doctor, you're not going to be like, well, you're only a doctor because your parents are a doctor. Because if there was a modeling school that you had to go to, an equivalent of like MIT, an equivalent of Harvard, would she have gone? I doubt it. That's the thing about nepotism babies. They always skip the queue. They always jump the necessary process, necessary steps. Brendan Shaw being a good example. He's a stand-up comedian. Joe Rogan's his best friend. Gives him the opportunity to come on a Joe Rogan Experience, which essentially propels his profile, even though he was relatively famous on his own right with the UFC and the stuff he was doing there. But still, the Joe Rogan Experience allowed him to reach a whole number of people he would have never probably reached without that friendship. Cool. We completely understand that, right? But there is a school in stand-up comedy which equates to going to open mics, right, and going on the road and doing triple runs and stuff and playing for audiences that aren't your own to build yourself up as a comedian. He skipped that and just performed to his own crowd for minute one. Never ever did open mics to the extent that professional comedians do. Never went on the road and performed in front of fans that don't know who he is. It was always to his own crowd, which Nepo babies always do. They always cut corners. So if there was a Harvard for flipping comedy, or if there was a Harvard for education, or if there was a Harvard for acting, a Harvard for modeling, would she have gone? Probably not. Right, there's at the moment, what is it? It's flipping Juilliard. There's a performing arts university that exists, right? Colleges. Would she have gone to a performing arts place to go and hone her craft and then use that as opportunity to then go and do her career? No. You step out at what age she is. Under 22, I think she is, right? She's pretty short for a model. She might be 5'2", 5'3", and now you've got a campaign with Chanel. Most models don't have that advantage. Most models are already ruled out by flipping model scouts based on their height. They might see somebody that's got an amazing face, but automatically rule them out because of their height, because of their shape, because of their butt, whatever it may be. But you get the advantage to even be seen in that way because of who your parents are. Obviously, it helps that she's got a face. Cool. That clearly helps. But the attributes that most models have that they kind of can't help, you know, in terms of their DNA and their genetics, they're already counted out. But you get counted in based on your lineage. So to kind of compare it to doctor thing is insane. Because number one, if there was a school for modeling, they wouldn't go. And they'd obviously keep skipping the queue regardless. It continues. No, I went to medical school and trained. Okay, cool. Ever careful, she's quick to point out that by no means this means comparing the works, just a coincidence. But I also laugh that she tried to turn this into a men and women thing. There are plenty of nepotism babies within, you know, that are men that people also call out. I don't think it's a gender thing in the slightest, in my own personal opinion. But again, what do I know when it comes to these sort of topics, innit? What do I know?